All right, we're in some technical difficulties to start thing off, but guys, welcome to game number one of this best of three between Alternate Attacks and London Conspiracy here in the BTS Series 3 EU edition. We've got some qualifiers going on, and it should be a good day of Dota, so thanks for joining me. I'm Sindar, a bit of an amateur caster, so just doing this for some practice, but hope you enjoy the cast, and thanks for joining me. Feel free to leave any feedback on my casting. I'd much appreciate it. All that being said, let's take a look at where the draft's at so far. So, Alternate Attacks, they first pick up the Invoker and the Earth Spirit. London Conspiracy, they'll take Nature's Prophet, Enigma. And it looks like London Conspiracy did have the first pick, so remaining. Nature's Prophet. And then the bands looks mostly fairly standard. London Conspiracy taking out the OD Chen. That's a fairly standard opening ban, not wanting to deal with the jungle. And then, of course, the Beastmaster, one of the stronger offlaners this patch, and Lion, just a good all-around support. As far as Alternate Attacks, they take out the Lone Druid and the Enchantress, getting rid of some jungle there, as well as the Broodmother and the Puck. So, as far as lineups go, Lone Conspiracy with the Enigma Nature's Prophet. Now, there's the beginning of a nice push lineup. You've got the Eidolons as well as the Treants, and maybe if they want to commit to this, they could try going for something like a Lycan, get the Howl to buff up all those units and go for the early push. They don't have to, though. Both these heroes do scale relatively well into the late game, and going for a push lineup maybe pigeonholes them more than they want. So we'll see, I imagine, with the next pick if that's going to be their plan. Meanwhile, Alternate Attacks, they've gone for the Earth Spirit, Vengeful Spirit combo as far as supports go, and that says to me that they are looking to do some early roaming. Both these heroes, really strong kill potential. If the Vengeful Spirit's in lane, can land a stun, Earth Spirit can roll in, and that's probably a dead hero. So if London Conspiracy are running this Nature's Prophet in the offlane, he will be quite vulnerable there. And of course, Invoker, a nice combo with that. The Sunstrike can come out over the top, assuming it's Quas Exhort, which I imagine it will be. And the Bane will be the next pickup from LC. We've been seeing more and more of this hero just in the last week or so. No Diggity, favorite a lot. And Cinderin's been playing it quite a bit. I think it provides a certain amount of stability in the early game. It's good harass, good zoning. Plus, you've got the long lockdown. It's some really nice control. And you know, if you're okay with not having a stun, the Nightmare is really long duration and can provide a lot of control in team fights, especially for an elusive hero like the Earth Spirit. Now, Alternate Attack, they'll pick up the Sven. And this makes a lot of sense with the Earth Spirit and the Venge already out. Sven, of course, one of his biggest problems is his lack of control. He is kiteable quite easily and needs to be able to get on top of someone to do his damage. Well, Invoker, Earth Spirit, and Venge all provide a degree of control for him. And this is a lot of stuns coming out from Alternate. London Conspiracy, this could be a bit tricky. Now, Enigma, so far there's nothing that goes through BKB, so he may want to rush that. Because against all these stuns, it's hard to see how he's going to be able to get off a good hole without that item. Now, of course, Enigma not just good for Black Hole, but I imagine that they will want to make use of it at some point, at least. So, assuming that this is a Kefka Nature's Prophet for the offlane, London Conspiracy need their mid and their safe lane yet. Of course, they could run the Nature's Prophet elsewhere, but I think that the offlane is more likely. It's a much more standard choice. Windranger will be the pickup mid lane for Baby Knight. A hero that can match up against Invoker, and critically, a hero that can at least sort of deal with the potential roam from the Earth Spirit. You get that wind run out after the initial stun, and you should be okay. So it's a defensive mid lane choice. I think that's mostly the reason why they get it here. I mean, Focus Fire, always good. And Shackle can be a really great way of controlling and kiting Sven. But there's other heroes that do that. I think the reason the primary reason LC pick it up here is just to give their mid lane less of a chance of getting crushed early by the Earth Spirit's rotations. And I mean, let's be fair, Earth Spirit is a very solid support hero who can have an impact all game, but really, if you're picking him up, you want him to have a big impact in the first 10 minutes. You want him to move from lane to lane, help his team get kills, and, well, this is a hero that pairs extremely well with that, and that's the Batrider. So the gank potential of alternate attack is immense. The lasso over the top to hold someone in place for the Sunstrike. You've got multiple stuns following the Batrider drag back. Basically, anyone they catch with the lasso should be dead. And
10 seconds.
Venge is still in the pool, but LC, they've already picked their supports. Oh, actually, never mind. Venge is on alternate attack. So they cleverly preempt that, not giving Lemon Conspiracy any chance of having a hero that will enable their Batrider to get shut down. No, Spectre is the choice, and it's an interesting choice. Against a team with this much pressure, I mean, if this game goes past 25, 30 minutes, I think LC have the edge. But that being said, there's a lot of pickoff power on alternate attack, and I'm worried for Jalopy that he's going to get stomped a little too hard in lane. I mean, I actually kind of want to see AA do an aggressive tri-lane. If you run Batrider, Venge, Earth Spirit, and just dump on the Spectre for the first little while, the Batrider will get a lot, and you'll shut down the hardest carry in the game, for sure.
10 seconds.
So, could be an option. They may just prefer to go safe and secure Exotic Deer's farm on the Sven. Nothing wrong with that, but... Well, we're into it. Game one of this best of three, kicking off. Let's see what these teams can do. Alternate Attacks, the team I've seen very rarely, actually. Not watched a whole lot of them. And London Conspiracy, I've seen a little more often. But... should be a good one. I feel like these teams are relatively well-matched as far as skill level goes. And hopefully we got a full best of three out of it so they can both show off the full degree of their skill. So it'll be Kakor, I'll call him Kakor, on the Earth Spirit. Elisash on the Ventral Spirit. Nisha will be taking the Batrider to the offlane. Supreme on the Invoker mid. Now these guys are already getting scouted out by the Treant from Kefka, who's still in base, sending out those free treants. And the only hero then we haven't touched on is Exotic Deer on this Sven. On the Radiant side, it'll be Solon taking the Bane into the support role. Jalopy will be farming on the Spectre. Steph Style taking the Enigma to the jungle. It'll be Baby Knight on your Windranger, and that leaves Kefka on this Nature's Prophet. And it looks like there may be a bit of a clash at this top rune here. Solon is in the area, but ATN have brought the whole gang in, and I don't think LC should contest here. But they're going to. Stun comes out on a Baby Knight, though, and Exotic Deer can follow up, but the Rin Runner's out, and he will be safe. In fact, just doing a little chip onto Kakor. But that'll be the end of it. So, Elisash getting a little aggressive, but the Sven decides not to go for the follow-up. Windrun taking level 1. It's not the end of the world, but he would have much rather had Power Shot, and he may be able to get punished by Supreme here because of that, at least for the first few seconds. So it looks like alternate, they won't be running an aggressive try. This Venge is going to be hanging around in the safe lane, allowing Exotic Deer to just get out of control. And Kefka, he's not even laning. He's just going to go to the camp and get started early. Meanwhile, Solon on the bot lane, gonna get brought down here, it looks like. Pops the Fairy Fire, 3 stacks up on him though, he is super slow. And Kakor will finish that one off. And now Jalopy in trouble, 4 stacks up on him as well. That make that 5. He should be falling any minute. There's a TP in, so he will be safe. And luckily he's got a lot of regen, but nice dive by Alternate Attack. Not even a dive, just LC underestimating the power of those stacks. A sticky napalm, and they've got to be careful. This is the lane that needs to go okay for LC. If Spectre gets shut down too hard, then by the time he catches back up. And that being said, stun comes out on Jalopy. That's five stacks. Firefly is up, and he's down. Solon in trouble as well. Will just take some harass, but the Spectre falling, this is going perfectly for Alternate so far. And what Kefka's getting in the offlane is not making up for allowing the Batrider to crush them so hard in this offlane stuff style. He's level 3, so he's managed to find a little bit, but doesn't have Eidolons, and Kakor stuns him up, but will be able to just get away. Does claim the rune in the end. So how's this mid lane going? Baby Knight actually doing pretty decent. 8-4 versus 7-5, so fairly even, all things considered. And Sven getting absolute free farm here. 15-4, he's your last hit leader in the game. Enigma getting a little, but it's not really worth the trade of getting your Enigma farm in exchange for sacking your Spectre. Now, so far, the Earth Spirit has rotated out, but he is heading right back to the bottom lane. Just healing up, getting some more mana. He's level almost level 3 now. And LC do have some nice vision here, but if they let the stacks build up, it doesn't matter that they have vision. They have to be a little more careful with that. And Kefka is getting towards his level 4, so he's getting his XP. He's doing okay. 7-1 for him, so matching the last hits of Nisha. The difference is Nisha has 2 kills, and going for more. Jalopy, no stacks up on him this time, but the roll-in will miss, so that means he can get in the trees. Luckily, he didn't, actually. He goes around top and would have caught the Sunstrike if he had, so probably wouldn't have been enough to kill him, but it would have been close. That's 3 points in Exhort. It might have been enough. So, things settling down a little bit. Looks like the Earth Spirit wants to claim this rune, but Stuffstyle is not going to give it to him. And he will actually just roll away. Not getting trapped. Stuffstyle gets the rune. He is actually saving it. Never mind. Oh, he is. Who's he saving it for? No one. Oh, it's a bit of a waste of time. And there are 3 heroes. Elisash has rotated down as well. Jalopy going to be the target. Gets hit by the kick. Will be rolled on top of as well. Anisha is here with the Firefly. That's going to be a dead Spectre once again. And this is a really rough matchup for Spectre. I mean, Batrider, a great counter to the hero, just because if he daggers into the trees, it doesn't matter. You can still follow him with the Firefly. And Alternate showing it here. This is exactly the setup they wanted. The last bit back, Batrider really working out for them. And they'll be able to pressure this tower a little bit. Glyph has to be popped here. And no rotation from Kefka, who does have the TP online. But didn't choose to use it there. Realized that he couldn't actually save his Spectre and maybe would have just risked feeding. They may catch out Nisha, though. That's a nice nightmare. But do they have any follow-up damage? They really don't. Stuffstyle doesn't even have the hole yet. He's got Malefus, but the Brain Sap will be enough. So they do end up getting that trade, and that's a big kill. Unfortunately, it goes the way of Bane, not Jalopy, who really could have used that infusion of gold. But still, worth it. They finally get themselves on the board with that. It'll be 1-3. Now, taking our eyes off bot lane for a moment, Baby Knight still completely dead even with his Invoker here. So that's gone well for him. And unfortunately, the fact that Earth Spirit is spending all this time pressuring the Spectre means that Baby Knight's relatively free to do what he wants here. As far as the offlane goes, Kefka's still doing okay. He's fallen a little bit behind in terms of blast hits, but he is still getting the XP, almost level 6 up on him. Now Nisha looking for Jalopy. Kakor's in the area, as well as Elisash, who's rotated down yet again. They really don't want to stop the pressure here. There are 2 support heroes in the area, though. Well, Nisha, the kick will connect on both. Nice, but is there any follow-up? I don't think there is. They'll just clear up these Eidolons. Malefus comes out. And that'll be the end. Baby Knight's rotating over, actually. They may be able to get a kill here, as the Nightmare does come out. And this will be at least one dead hero, almost certainly. The focus fire is enough. The Shackle will latch to just make sure. And the Batrider goes down for the second time. So nice rotation for Baby Knight, ensuring that goes their way. And we'll protect Jalopy a little bit more, as the Bat maybe will force to stop making such aggressive movements now. Potentially. Taking a peek at net worth, Sven definitely very far ahead of everybody else at this point. Already with his Helmet Dominator up, he's rushed it. Not even going for the treads first. And has he started stacking yet? He has. So, unless LC can pressure the Sven a little bit, he's going to get absolutely stacked this game. And they really can't pressure him. They can't spare the supports. They can't leave the Spectre alone. It's just too risky. And he is still not even 6 yet. Hero going in on Baby Knight in the mid. Kicked away, though. That was not the play. And now Kakor may get caught out. The focus fire is there. Silence comes out and the ultimate, but nope. It'll just be a 1-for-1, actually, as Exotic Deer. Where did the Prophet die? Okay, the Prophet died in there somewhere. I didn't even notice that. Either way, 3-4 is your score. And I guess he was hoping to kick Baby Knight back into his team, but unfortunately just messed that up a little bit. And otherwise, they would have got Baby Knight for sure, and that would have been a nice kill. As he is tied for the net worth lead on his team with that Enigma. Jalopy's at least getting something now, but he is significantly behind his counterpart. The Sven's almost 2k ahead of him. And looks like there may be another rotation onto mid, but Baby Knight playing quite far back. Looks like they've given up on going for Jalopy for now, as they're moving their attention to this mid lane. Already, we got quite a stack here for the Sven, who I imagine is maxing cleave. Yeah, he's already got it at 4. So we'll take that very, very quickly. Especially if he's got Venge in the area. Look at this, 3 points up in the Vengeance aura. So Exotic Deer will clean that out very, very quickly and take advantage of that early farm lead to get even bigger. Now, set up on the bot lane, but Nisha's in the area. Solon just has to back. They can't go on this. But they're looking for it. The hole is available. Steph Style wants this. The rock will connect on just Jalopy, and the hole should be there. Yeah, they will commit it. Kefka's rotated in as well, trying to go for the extra. Will catch the Sprout onto Kekor. And with the Brain Sap there, that should be enough to bring him down. It will. Nice 2-for-0 pick. Hole committed, but definitely worth it, as LC needed that to get themselves back into some kind of equilibrium in this game. They'll also claim the tower, which is a nice influx of gold for them. And won't catch them up, but it will help at least. Meanwhile, in the offlane, Exotic Deer still is the tower. They bring 4 heroes. He just does it himself. They're pushing further, though. They do have the Eidolons and the Treants. But Glyph will be popped. A TP out will come. Nisha looking for a catch. He's got the lasso up now, but they're a little too speedy, and he won't be able to find them. Oh, Sunstrike almost finished off Solon. But he is okay. And mech completed by the Enigma. 10 minutes in. That's a pretty good timing for Steph Style, and that'll definitely help, as LC are going to want to group up probably as 4 and pressure whatever part of the map that Jalopy isn't on. A swap comes out from Alisash. They may be able to catch Baby Knight here. The Wind Run will get him away from that Sunstrike just in time. And TP in from Kefka. They catch the root onto Supreme. Is there any turnaround, though? Steph Style gets the stun out, but they don't have heroes in position, and the Shackle won't latch either, so Supreme makes it out just fine. Now, LC can potentially turn this into a push, as they do have multiple heroes in the area, and the tower is low. But they do have to be wary of the lasso. Bat, how's he doing on his blink? He's actually only about 200 away from it, so... this is where things get a little dicey, or I should say, more dicey, for Bundle Conspiracy. And alternate, they're doing a good job of giving Kakor some space. They want him to hit his level 6, realizing that LC are looking to group up and push and wanting that Magnetize available to deter the push a little bit. Or at least, when it comes, they want to be able to turn it around, and that's a big tool for doing that. Now Supreme has finished up his Midas, working on some drums, but there's the big pickup. Nisha with the blink. And should be rotating to Wulane any minute now. It looks like mid is going to be where the pressure comes out as the Venge rotates through. They're going to clear up this creep wave first, as this stack first. It is scouted by the Treant. I don't think LC can contest, though. Look how fast these go down. Good grief. Exotic's here with Assange already up, and after this stack, he'll have the Yasha as well. 12 minutes in. That's pretty good. So we got Solon and Sestile smoked up, coming around the backside. They've got this nice vision down, so whoever TP's in may get caught here. But they've got to be careful. If they go too far away, the rest of their team isn't really in the area. Jalopy has the haunt, though. And Kefka has the TP available as well. So never mind that. They have everyone in the area if they need it. And... this is a hard kill to get. It's the Earth Spirit TPing in. He's got the way of jumping out if he needs to, but that being said, Bane actually has the Fiend's Grip. So if he gets that off, there will be TPs in, probably a Haunt as well, just to ensure that he goes down quickly. And after off of that, they'll be able to claim this tower. Now, oh, Exotic Deer needs to restart as well. Okay. So yeah, after this stack, Exotic Deer is going to have the Sanjin Yasha. He can go for a BKB next, and... well, he's already about 2,500, actually almost 3,000, ahead of the Windranger, who is the highest net worth on the field for Land Conspiracy. So, I'm really getting worried for LC here, because with the Sven being so huge, and with the Lasso Blink available, you know, whoever... the bat finds is going to be dead. There's no question about that. Sven will one or two shot the person with God's strength popped. And at this point, I mean, LC, they do have split push options. Spectre can catch up in the jungle, can farm out lanes wherever his team's not pushing. The Prophet can TP around the map. He's going for drums, so he's going to be reasonably tanky. He can try and do some split pushing as well, but the catch from alternate is there, and so LC have to be extremely careful in how they execute those split pushes, and it seems like it could really go south very quickly for them if alternate find just a few picks. Windranger, 1800 gold saved up, so probably saving for that Ags. Could be a blink dagger, but a blink without damage, not really ideal. But it does provide some much needed control. You can blink for the proper positioning, maybe potentially get a shackle on the Batrider after he jumps in and lassos. So a blink wouldn't necessarily be a bad item, it's just given how far behind the Spectre is, they really don't have damage and they need it. As I mean, Sven already insanely tanky, and the rest of these heroes not really all that squishy themselves. And we're finally a go, and let's see what happens. The TPN, they do spot him. Do they have the range for the Fiend's Grip? They've got it. Backward will get caught out. There's the Haunt. Midnight Pulse over the top as well. That's an easy pick off, and now the Spectre Haunt shows where everyone else is as well. So they will be able to pressure this tower. Should be able to clean it up. Anisha looking for the blink. We'll find it onto Baby Knight. That's a good hero to catch. And he will be... No, not blown up. The mech is there from Stefstyle, who is caught with the stun along with Solon. But Solon gets the brain top off. He will go down in the end. It was close. But on the backside, Jalopy looking for Anisha. This is not the play. You are very, very weak, Mr. Spectre. And he will run away. Trying to get Anisha, but Anisha will survive. The swap! Okay. He could be in trouble now. The stun is there. No, Exotic Deer doesn't have mana for another stun, but Alicia does. And now they blink forward with Anisha. Jalopy probably going to go down here. Yeah, he will. So, ends up being a 2-for-1. They did get the Earth Spirit. Looking for more, though. Kefka gets Flame Breaked out, and that TP will be canceled. It's going to be a 3-for-1. So, all of attack really, really low, but nicely chased out, and they get three big picks. All three. No.
Radiant's bottom tower is
Bane was the
attack.
Other hero they lost. So, Radiant's two cores and a support fortified. Go down. And it looks like Alternate will be able to claim a tier 1 off of that as well. And I mean, Exotic Deer just finished the SNY, already has 1500 gold up towards his BKB as well. So, I wouldn't be surprised to see them going for the Roche at this point. Yeah, and there it is, Kakor. It'll go down so quickly. Alacrity on Exotic Deer. And where's the Venge? Not here, otherwise it'd be going down even faster, but she's not needed. And London Conspiracy trying to pressure across the map as best they can. They will be able to clean this tier 1 in exchange, but... Well, with the Aegis up on Sven, the pressure that attack can push with is very significant and will continue to beat on the tier 2s of London Conspiracy. Not looking to let up pressure at all here, I suspect. And it'll be a Maelstrom from the Windranger. Not going for the X, but a nice standard choice. It's a good item to push at waves, and they realize that they're under pressure, that Alternate is going to be looking to go on them. Stun comes out, it's just onto... summons, though. Exotic Deer will clean those up. And bam. He's got a Blink Dagger. He's going to use it, too. Okay, never mind. The stun was just onto creeps. So now 10k net worth on your Sven. 4k ahead of the leading farmer on London Conspiracy. And we're only 15 minutes in. And with that 4 points up in cleave, some stacks for him in the jungle as well. This is going to continue to accelerate. Well, they give it to Anisha. He needs it more. Working on that 4 staff and should have it shortly after these stacks go down. And London Conspiracy, they don't have a whole lot of options as far as defense go. Spectre, desperately trying to catch back up. Looks like he's working on a drums now, but he is so far behind at this point. Only 4,500 net worth on him. Even the bat, 1k ahead. And here comes the tower pressure. Tier 1 will fall. Blink forward, though. They catch Baby Knight on the backside. That's a long-range initiation from them. He was not expecting that. And this tower will fall. Glyph has been popped, but it will go down. And they can pressure the Tier 2, potentially even high ground off of this, as there is no Baby Knight for 30 seconds. Sven, though, his God Strength will be running out shortly, though. So maybe that's the end of things for now. And I mean, they'll claim this Tier 2, but... what I mean by the end of things. They won't be able to go high ground off of this. And Lasso onto Kefka. They get the stun and the kick from Kakor, and the Sunstrike isn't even needed. Just these two heroes could pick off the Prophet. And this is the problem with LC's draft. They've got a split pushy lineup, but Alternate have all the tools they need to catch split pushes and punish them hard. I mean, that's only the offlaner and a support who are able to easily solo pick the Nature's Prophet. Do Alternate have a mech up?
Radiant's middle tower.
They do not.
Denied.
As I say that, Spectre is caught out in the jungle. Oh no. Exotic Deer gets the blink. They've got really nice aggressive wards here scouting out the jungle. And that will enable them to see Jalopy farming this camp. They bring him down. And oh, on the backside, Anisha finds the Windranger. Oh my goodness, the picks are just non-stop. And Lana Conspiracy, you're like, oh, okay, we just lost our Spectre. They ganked down bottom. I'm safe mid. Nope. No, you're not. They're so efficient at finding these picks, and they only need one or two heroes for them. And with those two heroes in the grave, this tier two will fall. High ground will be next, I assume. God Strength is back online. Exotic Gear is saving it. And, well, 6-11. We're only 18 minutes in, but the game might be close to over at this point. And Sven is now doubling the net worth of your highest net worth hero on Lenin Conspiracy. Looks like they're not too eager to push in just yet, though. Gonna wait. Maybe looking to push out their top lane. They're looking for a pick, but they're not going to find it. All of Lenin Conspiracy is safely back inside their own base. Dire's top tower is under attack. And I mean, this is the weakness of Lenin Conspiracy's draft. They went for a jungler. It was a greedy choice. Dire's top tower they is under attack. Had weak lanes. The weakness of their lanes got punished. And now you're sitting with a Spectre who only has Drums Urn at 20 minutes. He's combined up with the Windranger, who has only a Maelstrom, 1,000 HP. If Windrun isn't up, basically gets two-shot by the Sven. And the Prophet, also incredibly vulnerable, only 1,000 HP on him. So you've got all these very, very weak, vulnerable heroes, and they can't man fight. They can't team fight. They also can't split push, though, because of the catch. So they go for a smoke. They're looking for some picks. They're hoping that someone is here pushing this wave. But bad luck for them. All of Ultra Attack is on their side of the map, and now Sven has a BKB. Loses his Aegis, but it's not really going to matter. His blink forward, they catch the rune. Nope. Swap comes out, and it looks like a very chaotic fight as Kakor may be going down here. Gets Fiend's Grip up on the backside, though. Jalopy, oh, is going to get blown up by the Sven. He is nightmared, but already two heroes down, and they've only lost the Earth Spirit. Solon will get caught by the lasso as well. That's going to be a 3-for-1. And Exotic Deer wants more, blinking forward. He may actually catch Beaver Knight, Baby Knight here. He's stuck around a little too long. There is a stun available. And is there any follow-up? Oh, the Sunstrike over the top, but not even needed. 3-shot from Exotic Deer. That's a mega kill streak for him. And 4-for-1 is the ultimate trade there. Now they're going to push in through the mid lane. This will probably be a lane of racks with no Baby Knight for 35 seconds. Exotic Deer is out of mana, but he's still got that 10-second BKB available. Didn't even have to use it in any of that. And Supreme with the Axe, you Alacrity to Sven. He stands on the high ground. He's going to disintegrate your base pretty damn fast. Looks like they're not looking to add that pressure just yet, though. Kakor are going to push out this top lane. They don't feel under any pressure to push. They certainly probably could, but no need to risk it. They're going to play it safe, take advantage of their lead, consolidate their stranglehold on this map. Look to see some dire wards coming out here in the Radiant Jungle and to coop LZ up inside their base. Jalopy is getting out on the map, but this is just so risky, as here comes the gank squad. Supreme might actually get caught out here as Kefka's rotated in on the backside. Has the Sprout available? Are there enough heroes in the area? No. No detection. Oh, that's unfortunate. So just desperately trying to get something done off the back of this, but not going to be the case. They just don't have the tools.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
Yeah, baby.
And, I mean, they're just being drawn all over the map. Not farming, not getting anything done. Let's take a peek at the last hits here. Okay, that tells you the story. Sven with 246 last hits. The highest on the Radiant is the Spectre with 103. But they just have no space to farm. None whatsoever. They're just desperately trying to stay grouped up. So if the one person gets gone on, they can maybe turn it around. But, you know, if Jalopy gets jumped by a blinking Sven and a Batrider, having four heroes nearby isn't going to save him necessarily. Oh, and especially now you've got a gem and a Shadowblade up on Nisha. The map just became an even scarier place for these LC heroes. And these wards from the Dire scouting out the movement of LC, so they know there are multiple heroes in this sort of western portion of the Radiant Jungle. And Sven, another 4k up on him. I imagine Satanic is going to be the next choice. He's already unkillable, but with a Satanic, he's more unkillable, I guess? Immortal times two? Well, a smoke will come out. They're going to rotate to the mid lane. Not going to catch anyone, it looks like, as all of LC is in the top portion of the map. But, well, at the very least, they may actually find someone. The smoke is running out fairly soon, but they got a little bit of time left on it. And, oh, Elsie's under this ward. They know they're here. Jalopy could be the target. The smoke is running out very, very soon, though. And they will catch him, though, as he walks forward. Spotted, stunned, the haunt. Oh, nicely juked, but Jalopy's still okay. They're going just to have to retreat. Wow, I'm really surprised they couldn't get him there. I guess the haunt scared them off. But didn't need to. He almost died just from the stun and the sunstrike. Was brought down to below half health. And does have the Yasha up now. Going for the Manta, I imagine. Nisha still has that blink lasso. They will get dewarded, though. And Baby Knight now going back for the Aghanim Scepter. So that's the damage they need against the Sven if they can catch him out. Of course, that's a tough ask with the BKB pop, but... Nisha hunting. He's got that Shadow Blade up. Saw the ward. Didn't go for the D ward, though. Didn't want to reveal. But nothing will come of that. Just a little hunt. And Alisash will pick up this DD, potentially. As they have scouted the Roches up, so I imagine that's the next objective. And yeah, Exotic Deer already rotating over. They're grouping in the area, getting the vision down. And LC know as well. A Treant scouted it for them. Are they going to try and counter this? I feel like if they try and fight at the Roche pit, they're just going to lose very, very dramatically. But they do have the Black Hole online, and maybe they have the edge at the pit. No, they don't. They really don't. If there's a Batrider on the other side, what am I talking about? There's no way they're looking to contest, and they'll just try and get some split pushing done while ATN are in the pit. Exotic Deer picks this up, and oh, he's got something flying out. I guess that's the Satanic done. No, he's gone for a Daedalus. Oh, okay. So now Exotic Deer is going to be two-shotting literally every single person on LC. If they can't kite him, then they lose. And there's no way they can kite him. Because there's Venge there to stun and swap for him. The Earth Spirit's there to control heroes. Heck, Invoker already has a couple points up in Wex. He's got some control going as well. And a Blink Dagger as well to find folks. And things are looking very, very scary for LC. I'm trying to picture a way they get back in this, but can't see it right now. They're still desperately trying to split push. The haunt comes out. That was a bit of a wasted haunt. What was that supposed to have done? If it was supposed to deter alternate attack from pushing, then it has not done so. And they will claim this tier 3. Shackle connects. But it's more or less wasted as they can't go in on that. And now Exotic Deer turns his attention. They find Stepstyle with the lasso. This is your Black Hole out of the picture before the fight even starts. Now Exotic Deer blinks forward. BKB pop. He's got the Aegis. So even if he goes down, oh, one shot. Look at that. 1400 crit onto the Bane, who is down with no buyback. Alisash getting quite low, but the roll in is there from Kefka or Kakor, who pops the Magnetize. And now Stepstyle has bought back. They're desperately trying to hold, but the base is under siege. The Rax is falling. Exotic Deer low. Doesn't want to waste the Aegis if he doesn't have to, but also has that as an option. Baby Knight just so low. Kakor will get the rollout. It looks like they're not going to commit any further. Don't want to have the potential of feeding kills, as actually, never mind, they're re-innate engaging with Nisha, but he doesn't have a lasso, and now he may actually pay the price. They will get the Meteor onto Nisha, onto Stepstyle, though, and Kefka goes down to Exotic Deer, so it was a nice fake back. They bait with Nisha and he does end up falling, but they do pick up two key kills on LC, and now with no buyback on those two heroes, they can push and clear out this lane of racks. Supreme a little jittery about it, though. Solon, no Fiend's Grip up on him, so relatively safe. But they're not going to go for it. They just back. Still got the Aegis. Can do that again as soon as all their heroes are up. And meanwhile, they'll just push out these other two lanes. And 2k up on Ella Sasha. I wonder if he's going for a Blink Dagger. Baby Knight spots Exotic Deer, but that's not the hero you want to catch. If you catch him, he's actually caught you. And Baby Knight has to be very, very careful. Has the eggs online finally, though. So that is a bit of good news. The problem is, even if he gets a full duration, it probably just barely kills the Sven at this point. He does have 2300 HP as well as 19 armor. And the odds of Baby Knight getting to use that to its full duration are basically none with all the control that Alternate have on their side of the map. Nisha now going for a BKB. And with that up, the only thing they have to control to go through that is the Fiend's Grip. And of course, Bane would really rather not use that on the bat. I think the Sven is the preferred hero of choice for that spell. But if Bane, or if Batrider gets a BKB, he may have no choice. And here comes the push. Back again. Aegis still ready. Exotic Deer with that Alacrity on. We'll take down this tower quickly. Midnight Pulse comes out and Shackle will connect. So he's taking a lot of damage from this. But has not used the God Strength yet. Tornado won't connect on anyone but Baby Knight. But just a zoning tornado. Waiting for another creep wave to come out. Sloppy has at least finished the Manta style, but really, what's it going to do here? Kefka desperately trying to split push the bottom lane. May be able to claim this tier 2, but I imagine won't be able to go any further. And may lose a Rax and trade. Swap comes out. Baby Knight gets stunned up. There's a follow-up stun from Elisash. Baby Knight will fall here. Windrun about to expire. But no, he gets the Shackle onto Exotic Deer. Kakor channel... Fiend's Grip up, the wall comes out to guard their retreat, but actually two have fallen on the side of Alternate Attack. Exotic Deer is back though, the Aegis has been popped, and with this they should be able to claim the tower at the very least, but buyback comes out from Bane. They really want him to pay for this. The Shackle will latch, and the Focus Fire coming out, but it's not enough. The stun connects, Exotic Deer being cutted quite well by the Sprout so far, and Supreme Nightmared up, so actually the control is decent from Running Conspiracy, but it doesn't matter. Exotic Deer and the Batrider manage to bring down Kefka, and now they'll find Jalopy as well. Kefka buys back, gets the nice spread onto Exotic Deer yet again. He doesn't have an Aegis anymore, and he's going to fall here, it looks like. Yep, will go down, and they're desperately trying to catch whatever else they can. But, okay, Jalopy, this is not the play. May go down to the burn here. Oh, barely saved. But the Flaybreak is there, and the Force Spirits. Jalopy just desperately trying to get away. There's a Creep Wave here as well. Run! Run! He's got 148 HP. He'll be fine. But that was... Oh, the Sunstrike! Finds him on the backside. Supreme will grab that, and... Well, he does still have a buyback. That fortunately wasn't a dieback for him. It was a decent hold for London Conspiracy, all things considered. They did force two buybacks out, the Prophet as well as the Bane, but they brought down the Sven twice, and they hold their Rax, crucially, in this mid lane. Now, whether it's enough or not, I mean, we're talking about a 25k gold lead for Alternate here. Experience is around the same mark, and that kill on the Sven, the line barely twitched. It evened out. It didn't go in their favor, it just stopped going downwards. So that's never what you want to see for London Conspiracy, but they may be able to find up a secondary pickoff here. TP is coming out from Kefka. They will be able to find Kakor, and that's two deaths in a row for him. Again, a support, so not the end of the world, but LC will take any pickup they can get at this point. Kefka saving up quite a bit of gold here. He's got 2,600. He's got the eggs, so realizing that he's got to go for this split push build. Of course, the problem with going Ags, Tenacious Prophet in this game is you're basically just feeding money to this Sven, who's going to be able to clean up those waves of treants very quickly. But It's really his only option. It's his only win condition is keeping these lanes pushed out, maybe getting into backdoor with Jalopy haunting in. And if they can't do that, they're going to lose. So it doesn't really matter how much you feed this Fen. At this point, he's already fed. You just got to live with it and do what you can. Supreme with that Sheepstick online now. Ugh. Won't find anyone, fortunately for LC, but doesn't really need to. They're just going to push out this way. Probably take this tier 2, as it is the last one standing on the map. They understand that there's no way London Conspiracy will contest a tier 2 at this point, as they're just desperately trying to get what they can in their own jungle. Jalopy, how's he doing? He's actually got about 2,700 gold. What item does it go for here, though, that gives them some kind of edge? I mean, the natural follow-up to this build is probably Defusal, but I don't know. Defusal doesn't do a whole lot for you against the BKB of Exotic here. He's the one you need to take down. Now, it looks like LC trying to go for some split push play here, but Alternate take base is way faster than maybe. And creeps are now in the base. Alternate, they're being patient here. They're going to TP back, defend the lane. And maybe I'll catch someone here. Blink forward. No, not going to be the case. He's speedy, though, but won't find Kefka in the trees. We'll get out safely. And push stalled for now, but they did manage to claim this tier 2. And, well, Nisha's sticking around. He's going to try and find a lasso. Jalopy a little too tanky for him to go on by himself. I don't think there's any boots to travel up. Oh, no, Invoker has them. But Nisha could get caught here. They barely miss him. That would have been rough. Manders to make it out, though. Now has an Invis. And BKB's finished for him. So the ease with which he can get a lasso off on the key target is definitely increased a lot here. And this makes pushing base so much easier. He can blink forward BKB. If he finds someone, then that's a kill, and then that's a lane. If he doesn't, no big deal. And Nisha spots out Kefka here. Is there a rotation from the Invoker? He's going for it. Firefly popped. And here comes the lasso. The TP is coming in from the Invoker. It's a little far away, but he's got the Blink Dagger. Moves forward. Sunstrike will connect. So will the Meteor. Kefka tanky, though, but the Deafening Blast is there. Will go down. And Jalopy in the area. But should be okay. Nice clean pick, and there's no buyback on him. So without Nature's Prophet to push out the waves, this is attack's chance to get all three waves pushed in and go for some more base damage.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
3,800 on Jalopy. He may just be going for a late Radiance. I mean, at this point, what else do you get that's going to have any game impact other than the Radiance? It's still really not an ideal item, but that's like, okay, he goes back to the Defusal. So this will let him at least fight some of the heroes. He still can't man fight Sven. No one can man fight Sven, but you know, as we saw last fight, Exotic Deer, he's not completely invincible if he's alone. If you manage to kill off the rest of his team somehow without him destroying you in the process, then they do have the control to deal with him. But, well, he's got an Aegis yet again. And instant smoke comes out from Alternate. They're going to make something happen off of this, whether it's a pick, whether it's buildings. Either way, someone is going to die. And my guess is it's someone on LC. As they smoke right up into the base, Vision is there. Who are they going to catch? The swap is available. They're just waiting for someone to come defend this creep wave. This is scary for London Conspiracy. The trap has been prepped. And Exotic Deer will just reveal it. He will get shackled up. This is maybe a chance. Sunstrike will miss on Solon. Glyph has popped. Exotic Deer just backs up. They've got the Aran. He'll heal back up. Go back in. He's got a Satanic as well, so can always just heal himself back up off of the back of that once he pops his BKB. I imagine he'll save the BKB for a second life. Nope, he wants to go. Pops it, but unfortunately gets gets controlled up at the same time. Sestal jumps in, trying to get the hole off, but won't do so. He does go down, got buyback. LSH will fall as well. Kakor going down on the backside as well. And the Aegis has been popped. That's a team wipe for LC. Holy crap. And Exotic Deer now. This Nature's Prophet doing so much to control the Sven. The Shackle is there. The Focus Fire as well. And that's a team wipe plus Aegis. They did lose their racks for that, though. But they didn't even have to burn the Black Hole. They tried to go for the Black Hole, didn't get it. And they still won that fight incredibly convincingly. What a conspiracy. Where did that come from? Unbelievable fight from them. And that'll have been a pretty massive swing. No, maybe he hasn't fully registered yet, but that's going to be... If that's under 5k gold, I will be shocked. Of course, they did lose the racks, unfortunately. That's a lot of gold going back alternate's way as well, I have to say. But LC could not have asked for a better hold at this... how far behind they were to be able to hold it. And holy crap, before that fight Spectre had just picked up the defusal. Now with that he gets a radiance. That's, there's got to be, oh look at that tick. Okay, yeah, so that's gone from I'm gonna call that 30k. That's probably about a 7 or 8k gold swing. And Spectre finally starting to get something. Kafka as well now has the eggs. Octarine, do they actually have a shot at this? I mean, okay, things are still super hard for them, let's be clear. They have are down two lanes of racks, and the top is vulnerable. And the thing is, alternate, they can just put get another Aegis up onto the Sven, put him on high ground, and chip away. They don't have to go for a lot of pressure to be able to take this building down. And, you know, if they just sit there and chip away, slowly the other lanes are going to be pushed in. So, well, after that fight, though, I mean, LC, you gotta have hope that they can actually pull this out. It would be an amazing turnaround if they end up winning this game. Like, the amount of times teams come back from 30k deficits in the pro scene, you can count on basically one hand. So it's been very impressive from them. And Exotic Deer, I mean, he's about as big as he can get at this point. He can get a Moonshard as well. He can probably sell the Sanjin Yasha for maybe another damage item, potentially an Assault Cuirass. But he's about as stacked as he's going to get. And the thing is, LC do have a Tricore. And, I mean, Bat, he's an amazing hero to have late, but he's not damaged. Supreme and Exotic Deer are your only damage. And, well, I mean, we saw it. Exotic Deer, maybe, honestly, sell the Sanjin Yasha and just get a Quelling Blade. Just a Quelling Blade would be a better item at this point. Because he keeps getting controlled by these constant sprouts from Nature's Prophet. And, I mean, the cooldown on Sprout with the Octarine is only 6 seconds. And it lasts... 6 seconds. So he can be permasprouted. He really needs a Quelling Blade. Maybe just go a BKB or Battle Fury just for that. I would almost say it's worth it. Or either that or they need to go mass four steps on the supports. Kakor has one. But he died relatively early last fight. Kick. Lands on Jalopy. There is no follow-up though. Looks like they may have caught Kefka. Exotic Deer blinks forward. Goes for the double hit. But the buyback is out from the Wind Ranger. Okay, they killed off the Wind Ranger earlier. Exotic Deer, though, caught by the Black Hole. There's the Focus Fire coming out, and his BKB is expended. This is going to be his death. Tornado comes out. But, again, an important pick. And he's in the grave for 93 seconds. Does have buyback, but definitely doesn't want to spend it. And this gives LC further time to come back into this game. And Baby Knight now has a Blink BKB on top of his eggs. And they, again, they didn't even manage to kill the Nature's Prophet off of that because Sven got sprouted. And once he's sprouted, there's literally nothing he can do. Seriously, sell your Sanjin Yasha, get a Quelling Blade. It's the better use of the item slot. As absurd as that is to say. Now Supreme maybe catches Okefka here. But maybe Kefka's catching on Supreme. Deafening Blast Meteor comes out, does a lot of damage, but backup has arrived. The Shackle will latch, and this will be Supreme going down. That's an unfortunate time for DC. A really unfortunate time for it. As Jalopy has just spotted the Batrider. Kakor rotating through, has the Guardian Greaves, so Nisha may be able to turn on Jalopy here. Magnetize is available. But with the Sven down, you're fighting 4-5. Supreme is shackled up and will be falling any minute. Actually, he's Fiend Scripted as well. So he's going down for sure. So that's going to be 2 dead. So almost certainly Nisha is just going to have to run. His Shadow Blade is on cooldown. So if he can Firefly up to the high ground and TP out. But I don't know if he can do that. What is there to cancel his TP? He's got BKB and 18. That's not soon enough. If someone has a blink in 5... He's not needed to kill this Invoker, so if he turns around, runs this way, blinks forward and gets the stun off onto Nisha when he goes to the TP out, this could be another catch. Could be a 3-0. And, I mean, that's, again, Kefka just a little too tanky. Supreme thought he could get a solo kill, but not going to be the case. This guy's got 2200 HP. He's not a walk in the park, and he manages to get the turnaround, gets the sprout, and all of LC rotate over very, very quickly. Find the pick. And all of a sudden, LC right back in this game. I mean, the gold graph still has alternate significantly far ahead, but that's not the whole story. This gold lead has stopped translating into objectives. Now, Roshan will be online in a couple of minutes, just in time for when Sven is back. But, you know, if they get the Aegis and then don't clear out this lane of Rax, then I almost want to give the edge to LC at that point. Now, it's still going to take a lot of coordination from LC to win this. But they've demonstrated in the last 10 minutes or so that they still have what it takes to find the right pickoffs. And, well, what looked like an open and shut game may end up being a real squeaker here. Now, it looks like everyone's back. Here we go. Supreme, almost certainly dead. I'm going to watch what happens to Nisha here. Nope, not ready. Can't connect TeamSpeak. Oh, man. These guys are having issues. Where do they play out of? Not sure. Let me just take a quick look here. So they're Polish. So having some pretty serious computer troubles. I mean, this game they've already had 2 major DCs where multiple team members have DC'd, as well as this now has TeamSpeak issue. So a little unfortunate, as it does really break the flow of the game. And it gives LC all the time in the world to take a break, just take a step back, to think about how things are going, to strategize for what they want to do next. And I mean, to be fair, it gives Alternate a similar timing. Okay, here we go. Supreme, he will fall. Midnight Pulse is there. Going for the TP out is Nisha. The blink from Stuffstall won't be there to cancel that. And the roll away is there from Kakor as well. So it'll just be the Invoker pick. But still, I mean, that's holy crap. That's a 2,700 gold swing for one hero. And you get picks like that, This lead is not going to stay so huge for very long. Jalopy, after the Radiance, has another 2,800. He can go for maybe a Butterfly next. And they're looking to claim this tier 2. With Invoker in the grave, they want to take advantage of this and get as much out of the map as they can. And the other lanes are pushed out thanks to the Nature's Prophets, so they can take their time on this. Treants and Eidolons beating on the tower. They're not really committing to this. The rest of the heroes staying fairly far back, but they will claim the tower in the end. And they are scouting out everyone else on alternate. So maybe look to push high ground, at least force the Invoker buyback. Maybe that's a little too greedy. Yeah, it looks like they're not going to commit. Alternate attack is back. Or rather, Exotic Deer is back. Kefka already in bot lane. Already starting to push this one out. He's got another 5k gold up on him. Wouldn't be surprised to see a refresher coming out any minute. He'll save for buyback, obviously, but... Well, alternate, they need to get a pick off of their own. Boots of Travel's coming in. He's got the Blink Dagger. Who are they going to catch? They will catch Baby Knight, and this is a big one. But he does get the wind run off and pops his BKB as well. Trying to turn it around. Not going to happen. The Sprout is there from Kefka controlling Exotic Deer yet again. But the supports did go down on the backside. So alternate attack at least got that going for them. And that'll be the end of it, it looks like. Kefka sticking around. Maybe caught, actually. Yeah, he will be. I mean, Sven's critting for 2k at this point. So it's hard to live against that. So three ends up being a 3-for-1, and that was what Ultimate needed to get themselves back in control of this game. Now they can get the lanes pushed out with Prophet down for 60. They can finally get the lanes in an equilibrium that favors them, and that'll enable them to actually get to the base. And it won't take long. Like, all they need is Exotic Deer bashing on this lane of Rax for maybe 10 seconds, and it'll be gone. That's all the space they need. But LC, so far, have proven adept at not letting them have it. And I mean, alternate maybe now displaying a little bit of lack of experience in the late game here, as their decision-making has not really been great. They've played a little too cocky. Heroes have been caught out, and this game could have been over 10 minutes ago, but because of some sloppy positioning... And to be fair, I mean, some excellent play from LC. We're still going, and it's definitely not over by any stretch. Now, Roche is up in 1 minute. That'll be the next point, and I imagine that LC still not going to feel confident enough to contest that. So there will be another Aegis going the way of Sven, and there will be a cheese for probably the Invoker as well. A smoke is the play from alternate. They want to do that again, replicate their success. Lasso is up for the Bat Rider here. But all of LC is playing pretty far back. Firefly may run out soon. Oh, he's actually really speedy. Do they have any vision inside the base? They don't. And there's a counter smoke from LC, but they may get caught out on the backside, not expecting Nisha from this direction. PKB's instantly popped to plenty. Nisha will get swapped out, almost died. But on the other side, Aliash will be the consequence. Black Hole onto two. Exotic Deer caught out. Doesn't even get the stun off on the backside, but is there enough to control him? No, he pops his PKB. But the Sprout, the continual Sprout, the Sven can do nothing. He will go down yet again. Nisha's going to fall as well. Now Supreme, vulnerable. Kakor will fall as well. Baby Knight doing work. And the Sprout! The Sprout is the spell of this game. It is controlling alternate. They can't get anything done. That's another team wipe for them. And now LC can claim a Roche of their own. Oh, man. You got 30k net worth, Sven? Too bad. You can't hit anybody because you're constantly surrounded by trees. I'm so serious that he should just sell this Sanj and get a Quelling Blade. Like, he could have maybe fought with that. He could have got some hits off. If he hits a hero twice, they die. All he needs to do is get to a hero and hit them, and they die. But he can't do it. He can't do it. And Baby Knight will claim the Aegis, giving it to Jalopy almost certainly. He'll claim the cheese for himself. And thanks to the Prophet, all the waves are pushed to the other side of the river. Unbelievable. And what was once a 30k gold lead has been shrunk to about a 15k. XP almost zeroed out at the 48-minute mark. Unbelievable. These holds from LC have been spectacular to watch. And Baby Knight now with the Boots of Travel. 3,800 up on him. I wouldn't be surprised to see him go for Daedalus next. Of course, he could just decide that he needs more defensive items, but I think if as long as they get some damage out, then if you can blow up the supports of alternate attack quick enough and not give Sven the support he needs to keep fighting, Mima, Supreme, may catch a couple heroes here, but no, they spot him. They've got a gem. Midnight Pulse is there. Shackle will connect, and the Fiend's Grip is there over the top. 112 seconds. He is down with no buyback. And Black Hole up in 48, but they don't need to wait for that. Jalopy now with the Aegis and a heart can frontline and just hit the racks. And alternate. Things are starting to feel a little desperate for them. They haven't been able to get anything done on this map for about 20 minutes. And sure, they've got two lanes of racks down, but against a Spectre and against a Maelstrom Windrunner, that's not really an issue. Jalopy can... not even to mention the Nature's Prophet, who can keep these lanes pushed till the cows come home. LC, they're going to get their first lane of racks here, it looks like. And they have no reason to back. Glyph will be popped. And split push is happening. Sven pushes down the bottom lane, manages to finish off that range ratch, which has been sticking around for forever. But if it's a base race, then, well, Swap comes out. Eliash is just trying to distract them so Sven can go on the base. But he's questioning himself. He's deciding to go back, maybe? Has the TP, not using it. He's waiting. Don't know what he's waiting for. Baby Knight. They're trying to clear off the heroes. Kakor will fall as well. Three heroes down, and it may be a base race. Windrangers come back, though. Sven has to blink out. Jalopy, meanwhile, continues to work on these buildings. They catch Nisha on the backside. And they are going to go for a nope. Turn around, back to the buildings, back to what matters. Sven is back in his own base now. This melee Rax has not fallen yet. Will do so now. And they try and go in Jalopy, but he's got a heart. He's still very, very healthy. And this will be the second lane of Rax, it looks like. Tornado, EMP, won't connect. And Jalopy goes right back in. No fear whatsoever. And Baby Knight, he's going to push out this lane so that Sven can't do any backdoor shenanigans. And they may be able to claim Nisha here. Supreme blinks forward. He's back up now. But LC... they feel the power of the position they're in. They're not backing. Aegis is still up. They do get the lasso on a Kefka. This would be a huge kill. They pull him inside the base, and on the backside, they've hexed up the Baby Knight, but he turns around, brings down the Invoker yet again. That's 98 seconds on the sideline. Now Exotic Deer controlled up. Black Hole just on him, but that's all they need. That's all they need to kill. He's down for 100. Instantly buys back. Now they'll find Kakor as well. He does not have a buyback. He's down. That's three heroes down, no buyback. This is just game. I don't think there's any way Alternate can come back from this. And Jalopy, he's already onto the tier fours. They understand the position they're in. Nisha slept up. Going to try and force himself away, but they do have a gem, and they will bring him down in the end. He does have a buyback. Will be forced to pop it right away. They need a lasso desperately. But Jalopy, he's just too big. And even if they find him, he's got the Aegis. Trying to push him off the tier fours, but it's not going to happen. In fact, they're looking for Nisha. Exotic Deer slept up, just controlled. The Sprout is there again. Someone get this guy a Quelling Blade. He's going to try and hit some heroes now, but he just can't. Pops the BKB. He can't fight Jalopy. He can't fight Baby Knight. Who can he go for? He's surrounded by four, and that's GG. LC do it. Unbelievable performance from them, bringing that back from the brink of disaster. What a game. And that's only game one, folks. Game two will be coming up right away, so don't go anywhere. Stick around for more exciting Dota. I'll be right back.